Just wanted quickly to show you, I know there's quite a few trees in the way, but this is the viaduct, the Mozzle Trail, just beyond there, like a few metres, is the Millers Dale station, but I just want to show you this grand viaduct here. As you can see, there is actually two of them. The one with the arch, that is the newer one. The one with the straight edge, that's the original old one. They actually built two, but it became so busy that it had to build a second one. And this is the other end of the viaduct. See, there's again, there's two bridges, an arch one, and just the other side, there's a metal, you can just about see there, there's a metal bridge. Just peeping through there. And this is what it looked like back in the day, 1952. That one's around about 1910. And that was near 1900. You notice there's only one, by stead. They originally had, as it says here, two main platforms, but in 1953 further platforms were added, as well as construction of the second viaduct across the valley. It was one of the few stations to have a post office. That's what it looked like today, sadly. They're just turning it into a restaurant, well, a cafe at the moment. And they're just doing up the paint on the bridge. Now this is the viaduct. Now as you can see, that metal fence is, hadn't been painted probably since it's built, I should imagine, or something. Now that's what they've been painting for the last month. As you can see, it's got this nice painted grey, but they've only done the top bit, but you can see where they've stopped. All the underneath they haven't touched yet. I don't know if they will, but you can see the difference anyway between the new paint and the old paint. It's very cracked and rusty, but it looks much better now that they've painted it up. And they did have like a large canopy. They put loads of scaffolding all over it so they could keep paint nice dry while they're painting it. You can see this is what it used to look like. This is this bridge here, this viaduct. You can see it's very got all this plants. I can't remember what it's called now, but you know what it's called. It's a long way down. So, I mean, they do look after it, obviously, because they've just spent quite a lot of money in painting it. And that's got like little arches for it, crosses over. Just now on those brick supports there, I don't know if you can actually see, I can show you, there is. There you go. A little secret ladder. I don't know how well you can actually you can just about see that there. You can see that little secret ladder. There you go. Just there. You can just about see it. And there's another one on that support as well, and it doesn't even reach the bottom there, it just seems to be a bit of a gap, so if you do go down that ladder you have to do a little jump from the bottom rung to the actual support there. Just thought I'd show you this really magnificent viaduct, see it with the road and the river there. River Wye, I think it's called. Anyway, let's head for this secret location. See, I'm at the entrance of my secret location, and already I found some railway shoes. You can just see them there, and another one just there, another one just here. Very dug deep, and see that goes in there, and it just helps to jam the rail in. Oh, and there's another one over here as well. I'll go elsewhere to the secret location. I'll show you a whole load more.
This is my little secret location. I know it doesn't look much, just looks like a whole load of trees and bushes and dead twigs and that, but look closely. What do you see there? A railway shoe, complete with a screw, and it says S on it. There's NBN or something, 30. And there's some more of these. Like, this obviously goes in there. I think this is a broken one. Should be another bit there. Now, I'm not quite too sure if I'm supposed to be here, because just there, as you can see, that's a working railway. It's a freight line only, because I've only ever seen freight trains. I've never seen any passenger trains. So, this is why it's a secret location. Now look at this one. Look, 1965 it says there. So we now know how old some of these are. Some of these actually have a date on it. And it says check there. 95 RBS. I've been here before. Look at this one. It actually says, how well can you read that? It actually says LMS on that one. Maybe WW there, and it says letter S on it. Now I'm not quite too sure I'm actually supposed to be here, because of obviously the working railway line, so I might have to suddenly dash out the way if I hear an engine coming. I don't want to be seen. Don't know if I'm supposed to be here or not, but just wanted to show you my find, what I found. There's another shoe here. Again, on the screen it says LMS. This one, I think that one also says LMS just, I think. It says CC there. Oh, that says, I think that says BR in brackets S, probably British Railway South. Looks like I've got a number 2 there. So quite interesting markings on these shoes. A load more over here. This is all me here. So I've been here before, and I found all these old screws, and I've put them here so if anybody else comes here they can actually see. Look, there are. See, BR, British Railways. Got 951 BS. This is quite exciting. And there's more of these. Got these, what go in there,
you know, little jammers, I'm not quite too sure. There's some metal ones. Oh, here we go. See, there's more of these. Got one of these. Don't think these got a mark on them. Got that one there. And then we've got there's another one here. So there's three types. Oh no, four types. We've got this wooden one here. Got this one here. And then this other metal one. These metal ones don't have any markings on them. So there's no date, no, don't know where they come from. It's a broken one there. I think this one's, yeah, that's metal. Okay, so maybe we've got six type even in. So five metal, one wooden. Maybe that's perhaps what they're called, jammers. Because I look, like you can see if I go, you can just about see what I mean. I don't know if you can see that, but you can see on the shoe, on the rail, on the side rail. I don't know how well you can actually see that, but you can see where they've been jammed in to make it a nice tight fit. Show you close up, bit like that, and then something like that, and then the rail fits. I don't know how, but somehow the rail fits in the gap as well, just to jam it in somehow. Oh look, on this one, 1961. Again, don't know how well you can see that, but that says LMS, London, Midland South, I think that is London, Midland South, I'm not sure, can't remember. Looks like 39 maybe, or 36 or something. See, there's loads of these old railway shoes here. Yeah. Listening out for locos. I mean, mainly diesels will come over here, so. See, there's more of these. I'll call them jammers for the moment. I'm sure somebody will be able to give me the real name for them. More of these screws. RT, that says. That says AS on top. What's RT, anybody? What does AS mean? Railway treasure, maybe? Loads of these railway bits around here. Just want to show you something quick. Now, as you can see, there's a big rock there. There's a bridge there. Another rock there. Now, originally, I thought that, as you can see, there's one rail there. I thought one rail went around that side of the rock and another rail went through there, hence the bridge, you see. But I've got a photo I'm going to show you in a minute. Well, actually, there were two rails there and nothing used to go through here, so I'm not quite too sure what this bit is about. Oh, here's a photo right now. Here's another shoe here. Can't quite read what it says on it. 61 or, oh no, 19 perhaps. Trying to find some markings on it. There's quite loads of them here, all covered up in leaves and dead twigs and that. Oh, what's this? TWW, that looks like. What's TWW? You get the idea. Ooh. I mean, this is an absolutely great find here. Is that 1949 perhaps? Something maybe? See, there are absolutely loads of these shoes, jammers, screws here, just littered all over this place here. Loads of them. AS on top there. And again, LMS on that one. A great find here. They're all just littered here. And that, and it goes about 100 metres in that direction, down there. I'll just quickly show you the other end. This is the other end of it. I've just noticed something. I don't know, there used to be a bridge here, but it seems you've got like some sort of wall there. And then across there, like a bank. So I don't know if that was... ever a bridge up there. I'm not sure. Let's go and take a quick look up then and have a see. Now I'm at the top just there, a little way down. You can just see that little hill. Now, if I turn around, more brambles and trees in a way, but you can look past that. Seems to be a little dip, which may suggest maybe a narrow gauge railway went along here, maybe, I don't know, I'm just guessing. Look, you can see the land. Bit of a bank, small little bank there. I don't know if you can actually see that. Look at see, some evidence of a, could have been a small little railway. And if you look here, seems to be, maybe it was a, see the, over there, some big pile of rocks, maybe it's like a, an open mine, maybe there were, I'm not sure, some more pile of rocks over there. Maybe there was a, as you can see, there's a bit of a dip. Maybe it went down across here. Oh look, someone's had a fire there. Oh, there's another little fire someone's had there. I think people like to climb on there, on that, those rocks there, because I've seen little clips on those rocks there. This is interesting over here. Seems to be a little wall. I don't know what this used to be once for. The doorway just there. Up here, I don't know, there's now a little banking area there, I'm not sure. Go over here, seems to be a little path just here. Oh, there's a little path, and it goes this little path. This goes, and then there, just behind that metal box, you can see a platform. Now that, and then you can see, well, you can quite see, but there's a little old building there. That is Blackwell Station, and there's a loco coming, but step back a bit. Don't want to be seen. See what I mean by it's a freight line only? Very noisy. There's a lot of graffiti on the wagons. As I was saying, down there, Blackwell Station. It's a very small station, and then there's a very small Navvy's hut there. That is said to be the smallest station in Britain. And this is the other side. This is the remains of the other platform here. It's a very small platform, as I said. Apparently the smallest platform in Britain. What do we have here? This says 95 RBS. And again, it says check. Check what? And I found this one. A fairly new one. It says AS on top. It says NR there. This one's even got a date on it of 2011. CB12 could be. Oops. CB12 NR. I said 2011. They're all very interesting. this area. Now go to the other platform over there. Now this is a close-up of that Blackwell station. This is a smallest little platform. See the platform edge there? And that's that little Navvies hut there. See, I mean, not much to it left these days. We're on the platform edge now. And you can see there's another platform over there. I'll show you in a minute. Let's see, these would be two. This beginning of the Motzel Trail here, and then the train needs to come up. And there's a bit of a junction there. There's an actual freight line where you saw that diesel train a bit earlier, and I was somewhere up there. I came down the long way round to come here, and I'll show you this Navvies hut over here. See, original stone brick flooring, little bench, original fireplace, and actually got an actual wood burning stove. Maybe there's a little table there, perhaps an actual window frame there. It does open and close. That didn't much. Oh, can you see that? I'll show you that those metal things in the middle. In a minute. Nice wooden roof. One of these old sleepers, maybe, perhaps, that they used. Could be. Around the back side of it. See, this is the chimney with a wood burning stove. You can see that's the actual chimney there. That's the window there, and then we've got here. These old metal, there would have been a post here, if you can see. Got three of these. That would have been looked like that. With the wire going over the top, so about here somewhere would have been one of them posts. It's all very interesting. So I hope you like what you saw. That's my little interesting find of my location. So don't forget to like and subscribe and comment below, please. So I'll see you in my next video. Thank you. Bye.